Hello everyone, it's Leslie and welcome to day 3 of Stuffed Animal Safari. Today, we're on the lookout for a South American cat called the Jaguar. I'm gonna be really quiet though as I'm looking for the Jaguar because they're really good stalk and ambush predators, which means they can sneak right behind me and then pounce when the moment is right. So I'm gonna be really quiet so I don't attract any attention to myself in Jaguar territory. Let's see what we can find out there. Tell me to stop when you think you see something. What? Oh, you think you found one? Oh my gosh, good job everyone. Excellent work using our eyes to look and see what we can find. Today we're gonna talk about the Jaguar. And the Jaguar is the biggest cat in North and South America. It's part of a group of cats called Panthera, which includes all of the large cats, lions, tigers, and even leopards. This is the only cat in that group that lives in North and South America. The Jaguar has a variety of adaptations that make them really suitable to a variety of environments. They can eat a lot of different types of prey items, and they can successfully hunt in many, many different types of habitats. Years ago, the Jaguar used to be found all the way up into the deserts of southwestern United States. But as habitats have become more fragmented, and those big, big territories are being cut down into smaller parcels, the cats are moving down more into the southern American countries. So they spend a lot of time in the Amazon rainforest, but as I said, they can make a variety of different styles of habitats work. The rainforest is great for them because it's got a lot of their favorite foods, and it provides really dense foliage, which really helps them to stalk and ambush those prey items. It really helps to conceal their presence and helps them be even better hunters. Jaguars are really great both at swimming and climbing, and they swim sometimes even to hunt. So jaguars will hunt anything, but mostly focusing on iguanas, caimans, capybaras, and also anteaters. So they can eat a wide variety of different types of foods. They are apex predators, which means they are at the very top of the biological food web, and they don't have any natural predators. In the wild, even the smallest adult jaguar needs to eat about 3 pounds of meat each day to maintain basic metabolic body function. And that's really different from a cat that is a chase style cat, like a lion. They spend a lot of energy doing a chase, and they'll eat a large amount at one time, and then they can go for several days before they have their next meal. But jaguars have access to a completely different set of environments, and there's a lot more prey items for them, so they can stalk and ambush prey more frequently, and it does take them a little bit less energy than, say, a lion that's doing chasing to catch their prey. So they do eat more frequently than some other types of cats, and all cats are obligate carnivores, which means that they absolutely have to eat meat. The cats could physically eat plant material. They can chew it up and swallow it, but it doesn't have the proper nutrition for them to survive. They must eat meat. So jaguars are considered near threatened, and that's because of that habitat fragmentation that we talked about. As their territories are being put and divided into smaller parcels, it's hard for the cats because their territories will begin to overlap and they are all hunting in the same smaller spaces, which can cause a lot more tension and a lot more fighting between all of those different solitary cats. We have a treat today because we have found a mama jaguar with a couple of babies. These cats are mostly solitary, and the only time that you'll find more than one jaguar together is a mom with some cubs. You may be thinking that the jaguar looks really similar to another cat that you can think of called the leopard, but I'm going to tell you a few ways that you can easily tell a leopard and a jaguar apart. The first thing is their location. If they're in South America, it's a jaguar, and if they're in Africa, it's a leopard. But we'll take a deeper dive, and we're going to actually look at their coat pattern. And so the jaguar actually has spots that have rosettes or eyes in the middle that are a slightly different color. So their spots look really complex.
When you look at a leopard's coat, their spots are black, and they're very simple. They don't have eyes, and they don't have multiple colors. So those are two really easy ways to tell leopards and jaguars apart. We've learned lots of really great information today about our jaguar, and I hope that we see you tomorrow for day 4 of Stuffed Animal Safari. We'll see you tomorrow.